Welcome back. In this step, let's get started with creating the update service so that when we click save, we can call the update service. Let's go to Eclipse. We need to start with the to-do hard-coded service to create the updated method. So what we'll do is let's create a method down here. It says public to-do, and I'll call this save to-do and to-do. In JPI, the save method is used to do both the updates and the inserts as well. So at a later point in time, what we'll do is we'll check the ID of the to-do. The ID of the to-do is -1. If the ID of the to-do is -1, then it means we would want to insert it in. Let's not worry about it right now. What we want to do is when we really have a good to-do with a different ID. What do we need to do? We would want to update it. This is just a static list. So to make it easy for us, the way I would do the update is by calling delete by ID and passing in to-do.getID. So I'll delete the to-do with that specific ID and I will add the new to-do in. I'll say to-dos.add to-do. So what would happen? The earlier to-do is deleted and the new to-do is added in. So I'm kind of taking a shortcut in here. Otherwise, we would want to add the to-do in. So if it's a new to-do with an ID -1, that means I would want to add the to-do in. But before that, I would also set the ID. So I'll set the ID to, what should be the ID? ++ ID counter. So let's check the ID and put it in. And in all the cases, what we'll do is we'll return the updated to-do. So what we are doing in here is creating a simple save method. This helps us to add a new to-do. When I'm adding a new to-do, I'm just incrementing the counter and adding it in. When I have to update it, then what I'm doing is first delete and then adding it. This is kind of a shortcut way. Instead of checking each attribute and setting the value, I'm just updating, deleting it and updating it in. Now, let's go to the to-do resource and create both the methods. We'll create one method to do the add and one method to do the update. We already have the details for it. To-do resource, we decided this a little earlier. So let's go ahead and paste this in. So to edit, we want to use a put. And to create a new to-do, we want to use a post. And that's the standard which is used when it comes to RESTful services. Let's start with the update method. So let's say at update mapping. And what's the URI? Is the to-do's update mapping. So I'll use this syntax as it is. So I'll just copy this stuff from here to here. Cool. Now I have the update mapping present in here. This should be update to-do. Instead of the update mapping, actually I should have used put mapping. There is nothing called update mapping. Control 1, import put mapping. We have the update to-do body ready. We have not really did anything yet. So we'll get a username, a ID, and path variable username ID. That's cool. And along with the update to-do, we'll get a request body in at request body. So we would have the updated content that is sent as part of the request body. And it's of the type to-do. So let's add these in as well. Import the request body. For the update request, we will typically send a OK status with the content of the updated to-do. So what I'll do is I'll do response entity of to-do. So instead of void, it's to-do. And now let's call the to-do service dot save and pass in the values of to-do. And this would return the updated to-do. So let's take the updated value of the to-do. I'll call this to-do updated. And let's return a new response entity containing a to-do. We populate in the to-do and we would say HTTP status dot OK. Actually, the same thing can be done by just saying return to-do and changing the return type to to-do as well. But this gives us more options. In future, if you want to extend this and be able to return other statuses back, then using the response entity gives us more options. Now that we have created the put mapping for this, let's look at how to create the post mapping in the next step. Until then, bye-bye.